Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the topic Scare of Class 7th Maths. The topics which we are going to cover today are Area of Scare, then we will cover the next topic, Scare of Natural Numbers. And then we will take the last topic for today's class as Pythagorean Triplet. This Pythagorean triplet, you have already did the concept in your previous class 7th also. So, the first topic, that is area of square. Consider one square as 1 by 1 unit. Then, what will be the area of this square? Do you know the formula of area of a square? Yes, it is side square. Then side square, since we have taken it as one unit, so it will be one square. So what will be the answer of this? It will be 1 into 1, that is 1 unit square or 1 square unit. Now take another square of different measurement. Let it be square of 2 units. Then the area of this square will be 2 square, as the formula is side square. So the answer of this will be 2 into 2, that is 4 unit square. Similarly, we can take the area of a square of 3 units also. Then the area of this will be 3 into 3, then it is 9 unit square. So, students, what result you will get it from here? If we will go like this for little bit more natural numbers, then what result you will get it? That one square, area of one unit square will be 1, area of 2 unit square will be 4, area of 3 unit will be 9, and it goes on like this. So what will be the 4 square? It will come as 4 into 4, 16. 5 square means 25, 5 into 5. 6 square is 36. 7 square, 49. This concept you have already did it in your 7th class. 64, 8 square, then 9 square, 81, 10 square, 100, and it goes on like this. 11 square, 121, 12 square, 144, 13 square, 169, and so on. So what result you will get it? If you will observe, the unit place of all these natural numbers are 1, or 4, it can be 9, then 6, 5, then 6 again it repeats, 9 repeating, unit place 4 repeating, 1 again repeating. Now, in case of 10 square, the unit place is 0. So, next number will be 0. And if you will observe, in other squares, the numbers goes on repeating. So, it means that if at the unit place, if the number is either 1 or 4 or 9, 6, 5 or 0, then that number can be converted into a square. But it's not necessary that it will always be a square if the unit place is either 1, 4, 9, 6, 5 or 0. Let's take one example. If the number is 145, then this number is not a square of any number, isn't it? But if the number is 144, so 144 is a square of what? Do you know? Yes, it is a square of 12. So, the unit place is 4. So, as I have told it, if the unit place is 4, then quite possible that you will get it as a perfect square. Now, take one more example, 124. Again, the unit place is 4. But it is not in the form of a perfect square. Now, take one more example, 120. Unit place is 0. Again, it is not in the form of a square. You can't able to convert 120 in the form of a square. But the number is 100. Do you know 100 is in the form of which number square? Yes, it is a square of 10. So, students, what will be the definition of a square? Can you tell me the definition of a square? Okay, so I will explain it. Square, if we will take the definition of a square, then a number which multiplied by itself only once, then it will be a square of that number. Is it clear to all of you? Okay. Now, next thing which we will talk about, the perfect square. Perfect square. Do you know what does it mean, perfect square? Okay, I will tell you. The perfect square is if one number is there and we can convert that number exactly in the square form. Like 144, we can convert it in the square of 12. Take any other example, 25. We can exactly convert it in the square of 5. Any other example you want? Yes, 169. It is a square of 13. Yes, but can you think little bit more? If the number is little bit at a higher end, suppose that number is 225. Then how can we find out that what this 225 is the square of what number? Or if one more number is there which is at a higher end, then There is one method which we will take it over here to find out our perfect square. I think all of you know that very well how to find out the LCM. So what we will do it, we will take the prime factors of 225. I have taken one example, 225. Let's see whether it is a perfect square of any number or not. Only remember one thing, that you have to take it the only prime numbers. Let's see. It divides with 5. So what number you will get it? Yes, 45. Isn't it? Again it goes with 5. What number you will get it? 9. Then only remember that you have to take the prime numbers. Now, see how to write it. 5 into 5 into 3 into 3. So, if you will observe, the numbers are coming twice. Both the numbers are coming twice. So, it means if the numbers are coming twice, then it will be a perfect square. Like this, we can able to find out whether the given number is perfect square or not. Let's take one more example. Suppose that the number is 144. Let's see. Take its prime factors. It goes with. Then again, prime numbers. Remember that only you have to take the prime numbers. Then it will come like this, isn't it? So let's see. 144. Write it in the prime numbers form. 2 multiply 4 times and then 3 into 3. Again make the pairing. But remember, while making the pairing, the same number you have to take it together. Now, if you will see, again, the pairing is there. So, it means that this is also a perfect square. I think it is understandable to you. Now, one more example, if we will take it, let the number as 125. Now, can you observe that 125 is a perfect square or not? Let's see it. 125. Then it goes with 5. 5 to 10. 5. Now, the factors, prime factors are 5 into 5 into 5. So, again, make the two digits pairing together. Now, if you see it over here, that one number is left out. And so, what does it mean? That pairing is not possible here. So, it is not a perfect square. Have you got it? So, like this, you can able to find out the perfect square of any number, or you can find out whether the given number is perfect square or not. Now, suppose that we will get square of one number minus square of another number. Observe, both of them are consecutive numbers. Now, if we have to find out its answer, then you will get the formula later on, but the answer will be of this will be 4 plus 3. The formula you will do it later on. So, it will come as 7. So, any two consecutive numbers square and then its difference. So, Take any other example, like 10 square and the consecutive previous number is 9 square. So this, its answer will be 10 plus 9. It will come as 19. You can do it with square concept also. Let's see. 4 square means 16. 3 square means 9. So 16 minus 9, it will come as 7. And same answer you have got it by using the concept. So this concept will be if the difference of square of two consecutive numbers. So what you do, you observe difference between square of two consecutive numbers. Will be sum of two numbers. Will be sum of two numbers. Now, can you find out the answer of 11 square minus 10 square? What should be the answer of this by applying the above concept? Yes, it will be 11 plus 10 straight away. 11 plus 10, 21 will be the answer. Do it with the other way. 11 square means 121. 10 square means 100. So subtract both of them, you will get 21. And if you will see, the answer is same. So the formula related to this concept, you will do it in next chapter. In some other chapter. Okay, so one more thing before we will go for the Pythagorean triplet. If I will ask how many non-square numbers, how many non-square numbers between 2 consecutive numbers, between 2 square of consecutive numbers. Then how to find out? Let's see. Suppose that 2 consecutive square numbers are 1 square and 2 square. So if you will solve it, it will come as 1 and 4. Now let's see, between 1 and 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, between 1 and 4, how many non-square consecutive numbers? Can you tell me from this example? Yes, it has 2 numbers. Now take one more example. But the number should be consecutive numbers. 4 square and 5 square. Then if you will solve it, it will come as 16 and 25. So let's write the numbers in between 16 and 25, all the natural number. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 and so on. So, let's see how to find out between 16 and 25, you have to find out non-square numbers, means the numbers which are not converted in the square form. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So between 16 and 20 there are 8 numbers. Like this we can take one more example so that you will get the idea. 3 square and 4 square. So it will come as 9 and 16. Now let's see. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. Now see, between 9 and 16, count the non-square numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So there are 6 numbers. So by observing these 3 examples, can you see some pattern over here? Look, in first case, 1 square and 2 square, there are 2 numbers. In second case, 4 square and 5 square, there are 8 numbers. And in third example, between 3 square and 4 square, there are 6 numbers. Is there any pattern over here? Or can you observe any pattern over here? Okay, I will tell you. 2 numbers in the first example is, according to the pattern, 1 multiply 2. 1 multiply 2. In second case, 4 square and 5 square, the numbers, total numbers are 8. So it means it is 2 multiply 4. You will get it 8. Same way, 3 square and 4 square. So 3 multiply 2, you will get it as 6. So what do you observe? Non-square numbers will be 2 multiply first number, 2 multiply first number. So like this, you can find out the non-square numbers between any 2 consecutive square numbers. So by doing it by the method of 2 multiply first number. So in all the example it will be, it is 2 multiply first number. 2 multiply first number. In third example, 2 multiply first number, that is 3. So it will come as 2 into 3 as 6. I think this concept is clear to all of you. Okay. Now, you already did the Pythagorean triplet. Pythagorean triplet in your 7th class. And again, now we will take this concept. This concept, again we will take it. Suppose that the numbers are 2, 4 and 5. Now let's see whether they satisfy the Pythagorean triplet or not. Now, in this case, Pythagorean triplet is related to the Pythagoras theorem. So, according to the Pythagorean triplet, the square of highest number or the square of the biggest number should be equals to the square of sum of the square of other 2 numbers. So let's see. Square of 5 is 25. Square of 2 is 4. And square of 4 is 16. So as I have told it, Pythagorean triplet is square of the bigger number should be equals to sum of the square of other 2 numbers. Now let's see whether they are equal or not. 1 is 25 and on the other side it is coming as 20. So this is not equal. So it means 2, 4, 5 are not Pythagorean triplet. Is it clear to all of you? Now, take one more example to satisfy the Pythagorean triplet. Example is 3, 4, 5. Let's see. Highest number square 25, and the square of other two numbers, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16. Now let's say it with the same method. 25 should be equals to 9 plus 16. So here 25 equal 9 plus 16 equals to 25. Now if you will observe, both the sides are coming equal. Both the sides are equal. So what does it mean? That the above three numbers are Pythagorean triplet. I think it is clear to all of you. Now, you must be wondering that suppose that we have only one number. Let the number as 6. And how can we find out the other two numbers of Pythagorean triplet? Now, for this, there is a formula which you have to remember it, that remember 2m, m square minus 1 and m square plus 1. These three numbers are related to the Pythagorean triplet. Now, I have taken one example. Suppose that first number is 6. So it means the smallest number, we are taking it as 6. So this is the smallest number. Smallest number. So let 2m equal 6. So what will be the m equals? This thing you did it in your 7th class. 6 upon 2, cancel it. From here, m equal 3. Now substitute this value of m in the given 3 numbers. In the given 3 numbers. So what do you observe? What will you get it? 2m. M value is 3. So it will come as 2 into 3, 6. Then take the other number as m square minus 1. Substitute 3 square minus 1. What result you will get it? Instead of m, you will put the value of m as 3 here. 9 minus 1, it will be 8. Then now put it in m square plus 1. Then it will come as 3 square plus 1. It will come as 9 plus 1. 9 plus 1 is 10. So from here, if you will see 6, one first number, then 8, second number, and then 10, third number. These three numbers satisfy the Pythagorean triplet. So 6, 8, 10 are the three numbers which satisfy Pythagorean triplet. Is it clear to all of you? Now, let's take one more example. This I have already did it for you let one number as 10. Then what will be the other two numbers? Let's see. The numbers are 2m, m square minus 1, m square plus 1. So let 2m equal 10. So the value of m will be 10 upon 2. M will come as 5. Then substitute this 5 in the given above formula. 2m, 2 into 5, 10. Then m square minus 1, 5 square minus 1. After solving it, you will get it as 24. Then m square plus 1. After solving it, you will get it as 26. So these three numbers satisfy the Pythagorean triplet, or we can say 10, 24, 26 are the numbers, or we can say these are the numbers of Pythagorean triplet. I think this concept is clear to all of you. Now, in next class, we will do the concept of square root. In that, we will try to find out the square root by repeated subtraction, by prime factorization, and by division method. So, what you have got it today, in today's class, what you have got it? We will recapitulate it, the square, the concept of square, what you have understood it, that in the case of square, first thing you have learnt about area of square, then you have learnt about square of natural numbers. And what else? Perfect numbers or perfect squares. Then you have done